Welcome to Open Sources. In this video, I will explain you something about the Enigma machine. So it's an encryption machine, which you see here. I coded it up in P5.js, and I also made a Julia package out of it, with which you can decode, encode, and also crack Enigma messages. And I will explain this setting in this video here. You can read more about the Julia package in my blog, which will be the first link in the description below. And for this video, I will explain how everything works, the number of possibilities of settings of the Enigma machine, so why they thought it is so hard. And in the next video, I will explain how to crack it. But you can also read about that one in my first blog post already. I hope you enjoyed this video. So let's start with how to compute the number of possibilities for the Enigma machine. So we have a version without the plugboard, just the three rotors and the reflector, or here I also call it UKW for Umkehrwalze, which is German for it. And we have three different reflectors. We have five different rotors, so we have five different possibilities for the left rotor, four for the middle one, three for the right one, and for all the rotors we have 26 possibilities, which multiply up to about 3 million. So let's have a look at the Enigma machine again. So first of all, I've set the plugboard to just the current setting, so everything maps to itself. That's what we just computed. Then I can click somewhere and the rightmost rotor rotates. And then if it rotates to a certain point, the middle rotor would rotate. And if that rotor rotates to a point, then the third rotor, or the leftmost rotor, would rotate. And then we have the Umkehrwalze or reflector, and now we can click on the letter B, for example, and see that first the rotor rotated and then it moves through it. And we can see also what we typed and the secret of it. Now let's have a look how to compute the different plugboard settings. So let's have a look at the number of possibilities if we only had the plugboard. That would be 26 factorial over 6 factorial times 10 factorial times 2 to the power 10. So 26 factorial because we have, for the first letter, we would have 26 choices, for the next 25 choices, and so on. But we have to divide by 6 factorial, because 6 letters are connected to themselves. So because we have only 10 plugs, then we can divide by 10 factorial, because the order of the plugs don't matter. And we can also divide by 2 to the power 10, because if A is connected to B, it's the same as if B is connected to A. So in total we end up with that massive amount. And now let's combine the number of possibilities of the plugboard with the number of possibilities of the rotor settings, and we end up with this equation and this huge number of possibilities. And that's the reason why the Germans thought that it's uncrackable. Let's have a look at the visualization again. So here we see the visualization with the plugboard again, and I've set it different rotors and different rotor positions and choose the reflector B. And now just let's click at a letter. It rotates first and then it goes through. So gets through the rightmost rotor, then reflects at the reflector and goes back. And you can also see that if I typed in O instead of I first, it would go the exact same path, just in the different direction. So you can decode and encode the message with the same position of the routers or the same settings of plugport and or other settings. And that's the case because the reflector is symmetric and the plugport is symmetric as well. And yeah, let's increase the speed a little bit when we type in the next one. So the rotor rotates, or the rightmost rotor rotates, and then it goes through a little bit faster. And we can even make it even faster. That's a good speed now, I think. So we just typed in an E, and we will type in an E again. And now you can see that the first E was an S, and the second E is an O. So that's one reason why this is much better than Caesar Chiffre or some other chiffres where the same letter gets connected to the same letter twice. And this is done because the rotor rotates, of course. And here we actually got another E. So this time the E in open sources. And that would be, so it's the same if we go from the secret to the typed. So that got translated to an M. And here you can also see what I did. So basically, normally it's you get a secret message and you might assume that the word love is part of it. And then you can check all the reasonable possibilities, which I will talk more about in the next post and also video. In this case, I just gave it the hint, I love Enigma, which is the whole sentence, and the secret open sources, and it should crack it, which means it should give me the setting of the Enigma such that this happens. And you will learn how to do that in the next post, or also in this post already, and more about in the next video, how to make it faster and stuff like that. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay tuned. If you enjoyed the content, please give it a like, share it with your friends if they also are interested in cryptography or especially Enigma. And if you want to follow the next videos, it would be best to subscribe or follow me on Twitter at OpenSourcesBlog. You can also follow me on GitHub at Vicunia, which you will see also all the links in the description below. And especially I want to thank my patrons who support me to keep this project on programming things from scratch going.